Hey, what's going on, guys? My name is Prestige. Welcome to the headquarters. I realized after uploading my videos earlier today, I never really gave an in-depth walkthrough of the headquarters to show you exactly what you're able to do here. I briefly explained it, but I didn't really go in-depth. So this is kind of like a walkthrough live commentary. I hope you guys enjoy. I kind of wanted to give you guys a better understanding of best practices when it comes to communicating with fellow players, increasing your social rank, and of course, that in turn means earning social score, and how you can do that the quickest way possible. So as you can see, the headquarters isn't really popping right now, and that's because we're about an hour away from the official launch of the game, but this is where you're going to spawn in. As soon as you select multiplayer, you're going to be planted right here where I'm standing, and then you're free to move in and do whatever you want. So not only is this a place where you can open up supply drops, interact with people that are standing around here, but this is a great place to take on challenges, whether it's daily or weekly, or take on contracts to complete in the multiplayer. So let's start over here with mail. Mail is the place that you're going to be able to pick up your payroll. Payroll is given to you every few hours, and this comes in the form of 100 armory credits. Right now, mine's a little bit glitched. I've already collected it, but it hasn't gone away, to say the least. And over here, you're also going to find little bonuses. Like, let's say Sledgehammer one day wants to give us all a helmet. You'll be able to find it here in the mail. You're also going to be able to find your pre-order bonus items right here in the mail. As you can see, I left Carantan in here just to show you that this is where you'd find the bonus map. You just select it there and it will automatically start downloading. Over here, you can find the quartermaster. The quartermaster is going to give you a whole bunch of different contracts that you're able to complete. These contracts do cost armory credits, and depending on the difficulty, they may cost more and more. So obviously these at the bottom here, 1,175 armory credits, if you don't complete these tasks, you're not going to earn the rare supply drop and you're going to be out of credits. Is it worth that much? Probably not, but if you really wanted to open up a supply drop, I guess you could spend the credits and spin it to win. Over here, you're going to find collections. Collections are similar to Modern Warfare Remasters collections or operations, and once you complete a specific collection, you will unlock that weapon variant. Right here, you can see the epic FG42, which is pretty nice. Now, it doesn't end there. Inside, you're going to find Major Howard. Major Howard is going to contain daily challenges that you can complete for supply drops or social score. You can also earn armory credits this way. Weekly challenges and a special order. This week, you're going to have to win a match in every single standard game mode in order to complete that and earn a rare supply drop. So that's pretty much everything that's here, but this social space right in this area is where a lot of the supply drops are going to be opened and where a lot of players like Face Melter right here is going to be interacting. The one thing that I can suggest right away is trying to get the attention of somebody. Like, let's say they're playing and you wanted to earn a little bit of social score. Hold square or whatever it is on your console and hit commend player. Commending them will give them a little bit of social score. Social score goes directly towards your social rank. As you earn social rank, you will be able to get specific in-game items, whether that be calling cards or emotes or, I don't know, I'm only rank 8, so I haven't really earned much yet. But I think once you go through and commend a player, it's more likely that they will commend you as well. If people aren't commending, this is one thing that I have to say, like, I always just commend everybody I see in the lobby. You could do it once per player. I think that's the only time you could do it. And obviously there's going to be hundreds of thousands of people playing, so you could do it hundreds of thousands of times. But that's the one thing that I can suggest. In the HQ, always commend players. If they don't commend you back, that kind of sucks, but at least you know that you helped out somebody else. The other thing that I can suggest as well is trying to get their attention, right? Like if you do a couple emotes and get their attention, they're more likely to commend you. Otherwise, a lot of people don't know that this happens. The other thing that you can do in the headquarters, which is about to happen right now, he's going to call in a supply drop. And it's likely that you may get some XP bonus. It's likely that you may get a supply drop yourself. Or you may just not get anything at all like you just saw there. But it's cool nonetheless to see exactly what they get. And if they get something cool, you could cheer them on, especially with your emotes, which is really nice. Let's go ahead and move on to the next part of the headquarters, which is the theater right over here. The theater is a place where you can watch live gameplay, whether it's an MLG event or something that Sledgehammer places in here, like a trailer or a little teaser for anything. They put their documentary in there that's actually uploaded to YouTube, so you could watch it if you really wanted to. Moving down the block a little bit, we have our emblem gallery, which is not actually open yet. I don't think so. So you can craft emblems, and crafting is always going to be there, but you can't upload them yet and you can't view them yet. So there's going to be probably something in regard to like an emblem of the week or some really interesting ones that get plastered up here when people come in through the headquarters. I think that's kind of cool. Down here, you're going to have your score streak range. You can go in and, of course, control score streaks, test them out, and do what you want there. Once you're in the score streak range, though, you can't see other people in it. I wish you could. You basically leave the game or you leave the headquarters in order to do this, and you do it basically in your own lobby. Over here, you're going to have the R&R tent. This is going to give you the ability to play old-school Activision games at a cost of 10 credits, which I don't think it's worth doing that. Over here, you're going to find the leaderboards. The leaderboards are important because, once again, if you wanted to check out your ranking or the top player that's currently inside of the headquarters, you can do that. Over here is a really important thing, the gunsmith. The gunsmith allows you to prestige weapons. You can create paint jobs. You can upload paint jobs and view other paint jobs that people created. This is going to be coming very soon, but this is one thing that Sledgehammer never talked about. I never knew they were going to be doing this, so having our own paint jobs, which it actually looks like it covers the entire weapon this year, is really cool. I'm excited to get in and start doing that. Over here, we have the 1v1 pit. I'm currently on a 5-win streak, 20 wins overall, you know, undefeated here in the headquarters, so if you guys want to catch me in the 1v1 pit, of course, that's something you could do. I think T-Martin uploaded a video earlier where I kind of got destroyed by him, but I got my payback. I got my payback just a little bit, and you can watch it from multiple angles, which is really nice. Now here's an AA gun. One thing that I haven't experienced yet in the headquarters is an attack, and I guess we can defend the headquarters with these AA guns, so it's going to be interesting to see what happens as that happens. Moving and wrapping back up around, we have our division prestiges. Once you rank up your division enough, you'll have the ability to prestige it, and you will earn rewards from that as well. Division prestiging is pretty easy to do. You can earn a lot of XP for your divisions pretty quickly, so I wouldn't worry about that. Normally right here, there's a dude that blocks your pathway, and this is actually the route to the general. When you're ready to prestige, you'll be able to come through here and talk to the general, and of course, prestige and get a bunch of fanfare. There's also another AA gun up here, so if somebody's in your lobby and they're prestiged, they'll be able to go up here and use that gun. We have another player, where's my kush? You know how it goes. And that kind of brings us back over to the firing range. The firing range is interesting because you can challenge players to the firing range if they want to, of course. None of these guys are actually in the lobby right now. I think they're actually creating their classes or something, so I can't really challenge. Oh, I can challenge this guy right here. So you hold square, do the shootout challenge. I'll probably get denied. Let's see if it happens. And wow, we're actually doing it. So we're going to be using the M1 Grand. Let's see how this goes. I noticed, like, shooting these targets downrange, that gives you the most points. It's almost like cheating, especially if you could take it directly from that guy. He's trying to hit those targets way back there. But the secret is to just hit these targets. Especially if you hit him in the center, you'll get +3 after destroying it. And that's game. This is another way to earn social score. But either way, it's still cool and it's a little friendly banter that you're able to take part in. But anyway, that pretty much concludes the tour of the headquarters. Once again, it's pretty barren right now. We're going to have a lot more people in here once the game goes live in about an hour. I just wanted to show you guys exactly what there is to do here for now. There's also some little secret stuff that you're able to do. Some of the secret stuff is pretty cool. Like, for example, over here, if you jump up on this ledge, which obviously I'm drunk and I can't do it. Jumping up there, there's a secret ball, which is pretty cool. You can pick up this ball. The ball then can be given to other players, and they complete a challenge with the ball. It's kind of like, oh, you found one of the secret balls. That's pretty much that. The other thing that you're able to do is jump up on the roof of this thing, and a bunch of people will be like, how the heck did you do that? You gotta come over here, and this is a hard thing to do. I'll just show you guys how to do this. You come up over here, you jump on this, and you get up here. That is the hardest part, jumping into that corner. You walk over here, Watch out for the invisible wall. Jump to this pillar, jump to this one. Run and jump over to the pipe. And boom, baby. You're up on... I got the ball, too. That's what I'm talking about. You run up to the rooftop. And there's actually a secret sledgehammer up here. Which is a nice little touch, Sledge. Nice little Easter egg you got there. But yeah, that's going to go ahead and conclude the overview of what there is to do out here in the headquarters. Once this thing is just completely packed with players, just send commendations to people. Hopefully the social score will be going up like crazy. And either way, I hope you guys have fun with the headquarters overall. Thank you all so much for watching the video here today. If you enjoyed, take a second of your time to click that like button down below. And speaking of down below, we have the zombies guy right here. He'll just take you into the zombies mode. But anyway, guys, I'll catch you on the next video. See ya. Peace.